We have to put some international puppets. That needs to be there this evening.
Okay.
Our media have asked about the possibility of, after they make their statements, having the Iraqi media address both generals, then having the Western media address both generals. That way the interpreter doesn't have to be interrupting through the American portion so much. Can we do that?
I'm not grasping what you're...
Let's say go to questions and answers.
Right.
You would make the announcement at this time, the Iraqi media, please address your questions to both generals. And then after the Iraqi media, we'll have the American media address. And that way, when they address them, it's just a direct dialogue back and forth instead of the...
But she's still going to have to translate for these guys because they're going to have the same answers. They would like to hear the answers that they want to hear.
Okay.
You know,
there's just no way around that, is there?
It really isn't. Plus, I already briefed at the predicate.
Okay.
That'd be good. Okay. Can I have your attention, please? The press conference is going to start in about 2 minutes. The way this is going to go, is that we are doing a live press conference with the Pentagon Press Corps. They will go first in asking questions.
You're going to have to speak up.
A little bit more volume. A lot more volume.
One, two, one.
So we will take about 5 questions from the Pentagon. And then, time permitting, we will take as many questions from you as possible. Closer? You can move closer a little bit. Good? Still off? What? Say something. Go ahead, say something. Yeah. Yeah, like you're translating. Say, I'm translating right now. A little bit louder. Okay, good. It's going to be quieter.
Bob? Are you ready in the Pentagon office already? What did he say? Okay. All right, then.
They're at Camp Fallujah.
I'm going to do that.
السلام عليكم. مرحبا. مثل ما عودناكم دائما نتواجد معكم وبساحة القتال، وإن شاء الله قريبا جدا راح ننهي الموضوع بأسرع وقت ممكن وما راح نعذبكم أكثر من هيك. أنا راح أقرأ بعض الأمور السياسية اللي بلغني فيها السيد رئيس الوزراء، والفريق عبد القادر راح يتحدث عن الأمور العسكرية، واللواء ساتلر هو راح يتحدث همين عن الأمور العسكرية والتطورات العسكرية. طيب. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أعرب السيد رئيس الوزراء عن سعادته للعمل الشجاع الذي تؤديه القوات العراقية، وبالاشتراك مع القوات متعددة الجنسيات في مدينة الفلوجة، حيث تهدف هذه العمليات إلى إعادة المدينة لسكانها بعد التخلص من الإرهابيين الذين يقومون بقتل العراقيين الأبرياء ويهددون الأمن والديمقراطية في البلد. وقد كان واضحاً بأن الإصابات في صفوف المدنيين قليلة جداً، وأن الجميع يوفرون لهم رعاية ممتازة. وقد اعتقل 10 إرهابيين من مختلف المدن، والشرح الآتي: 10 من إيران، 1 من السعودية، 1 من مصر، 1 أردني، و1 من سوريا، و1 يتكلم اللغة الفرنسية. وقد كرر السيد رئيس الوزراء عرضه للعفو عن الأفراد المسلحين الذين لم يرتكبوا جرائم كبرى. هذا وقد قابل السيد رئيس الوزراء برفقة السيد وزير الدفاع ووزير الداخلية مجموعة من رؤساء العشائر من مدينة الفلوجة، واستعرضوا سوية كيفية وضع حد للعمليات العسكرية، وذلك بتسليم أسلحتهم وعزل الإرهابيين عنهم، وأعلنوا عن تأييدهم للحكومة مع تمنياتهم بعودة سيادة القانون والأمن إلى البلد. وتابع السيد رئيس الوزراء مناقشته مع رؤساء الأحزاب الأساسية حول كيفية بناء مجتمع موحد، وكذلك الاستعدادات للانتخابات الديمقراطية. وقد تلقت طروحات تأييد واسعة من ممثلي المجتمعات السنية والشيعية والكردية. وتحدث سيادته مع السيد سكرتير الأمم المتحدة كوفي عنان، شارحا له أهمية العمليات العسكرية في الفلوجة، ومبينا تصميمه على إقامة الانتخابات لجميع العراقيين. جدير بالذكر أن فريق طبي قد وصل تو إلى المستشفى العام في الفلوجة، وهو بصدد تقديم احتياجات، وسوف تكون المعونات الإنسانية بالطريق إلى هنا يوم غد باتجاه المناطق المحررة إن شاء الله. المناطق المحررة والمؤمنة في الفلوجة، وستكون الإعانات الطبية جاهزة للتوزيع على المراكز الطبية في المدينة. أما فريق التقييم الخاص بإعادة الإعمار فإنه يقوم بالانتشار هناك لتهيئوا للمرحلة الأولى من برنامج إعادة الإعمار، حيث تم تخصيص أكثر من 100 مليون دولار للأولويات في هذا البرنامج. وشكرا. 100 مليون دولار.
An English translation. She was going to translate. I'm not sure if she can read that in English so everyone can hear the English speaking.
حابين تقريها بالتقرير هم يا الإنجليزي. هاي بتجي النقطة بعد هنا تجي الأعداد.
Can you just summarize it in English or?
Yeah, sure. Well, actually, first of all, the Prime Minister, he would like to express his happiness regarding the brave action that have been taking place with the militaries, the Iraqi militaries, and the multinational forces. And he just want to say that we don't have that much casualties in both the Iraqi forces and the multinational forces. And we got some detainees, and the number is 10 from Iran, 1 from Saudi Arabia, 1 from Sudan, 1 from Egypt, 1 from Jordan, and 1, we believe he speaks French. Up until now, we don't know if he's French or not. The Prime Minister had met with the Secretary of Interior and Secretary of Defense, and they met with the tribe leader of Al-Anbar and Fallujah, and they discussed so many issues regarding the situation of future of Fallujah, future of Anbar, and how we could contain the situation there. They give the Prime Minister the full support to help him to contain the situation over there. Also, the Prime Minister met with the leader of the parties, the main parties in Baghdad, and they discussed the security issue and the Fallujah's crisis. And they discussed how to go forward toward democracy and election. He got full support from the Sunnis, from the Shias, and from the Kurds. Also, the Prime Minister spoke with His Excellency, the Secretary of United Nations, Kofi Annan. He spoke to Kofi Annan, and he explained to him how the Fallujah issues is very important to the Iraqi, and we have to solve this problem as soon as possible because it's affecting the security in Baghdad. There's a medical team is going to arrive to Fallujah and to take a look on the hospital and what the needs of the hospital, how can they support the medical issues over here in Fallujah. There another team too is coming to Fallujah and to the Anbar and to estimate the reconstruction of Fallujah, and the Prime Minister decided to start with the reconstruction as soon as the crisis in Fallujah will stop or cool down. He nominated like about $100 million for the reconstruction of Fallujah, and there is many projects already in hand that we are going to start with it as soon as possible. Thank you.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بالنسبة للعمليات العسكرية اللي جرت ابتداء من الساعة 1900 أي السابعة مساء يوم أمس ابتدأ الجزء الثاني من الصفحة الثالثة. اللي هي الصفحة باء. أي الانتقال للقتال بالنصف الجنوبي من المدينة. بنفس الوقت القسم الشمالي بدأت عليه عمليات تطهير من بيت إلى بيت. قطاعاتنا العراقية والصديقة موقفها جيد جدا. بتنفذ الخطة بحذافيرها وبتوقيتاتها لا بل بتوقيتات قياسية. الخسائر أقل من حساباتنا بكثير جدا. أما بالنسبة للعدو فالعدو لحد الآن عملياته تقتصر على عمليات القنص. بمجموعات قليلة جدا 2 إلى 3 وأيضا يقومون بعمليات القصف غير المباشر بواسطة الهاون ولكن الآن بدأ القصف من خارج مدينة الفلوجة ومحدد الأماكن. هذه الأماكن ده تستمكن بشكل جيد ويكون هنالك قصف مقابل سريع أدى إلى نتائج جيدة أيضا. الأمر الذي أقوله لكم وبصراحة يعني أنا غير متأكد 100%، لو كنت متأكد 100% يعني أعلنه، ولكن أحب أوصل لكم أنه بعد ظهر اليوم بدأت حالة استسلام.
I want to be honest with you. I'm not sure, but I want to be, I want to make you sure that they.
أنا ما حبيت يعني حتى من قبل الأصدقاء أن أنقل لكم هذا الخبر إلا بعد أن أتأكد منه لأن خبرت القطعات أن تصور هذا الشيء لأنه اللي افتهمت أنه أكثر من 300 في أحد الجوامع سلموا أنفسهم وقسم منهم يختفون لأن احنا واجبنا الآن أن نخلي العوائل من الأماكن الخطرة فبدأوا يجعلون العوائل درع بشري لهم.
We try to transfer the families from the houses, but they start to use the like the armor.
Excuse me, there is one issue that he mentioned that now there is groups of the insurgent they are surrendering now, and there is 300 in Damascus, and they are negotiating to surrender.
هذا فور أن أتأكد منه 100% في لقاء قادم راح أعرض أمامكم العملية للصفحة الثالثة مستمرة و فيز 3 وأتوقع يعني ما عندي تحديد متى تنتهي وفقا للتخطيط ووفقا للنتائج اللي إحنا نطلبها. من الأمور المهمة إخواني جدا يعني اللي من خلال استطلاعنا للأماكن اللي شفناها وقعت في أيدينا أمور كثيرة. تحس في النفس جدا. أنا أترك موضوع الأسلحة القادمة من الخارج وبكميات كبيرة.
We will not talk about the weapons coming outside the city.
ولكن لن تشاهد البشرية أبشع من هذه السيديات. حين يذبح الإنسان لكونه موظف كالخروف. وحين يضع أحدهم على رأسه أقدس الكلمات لا إله إلا الله حتى يقصد. والملابس أيضا موجودة. هذا موجود. بالطبع مكان المجزرة موجود وتم تصويره وتم تصوير التجهيزات اللي موجودة به. للأسف يعني كثير من يعني مجرد موظف بالدولة لا أكثر ولا أجمل هذه جريمته فيجزر. ما نتمكن أن نذكر أسماء أو نذكر بسبب العوائل وما ممكن أن نعرض هذا الشيء على شاشة. مجمل الأمور العسكرية اللي أنا طرحت لكم إياها. والله الخريطة يعني إحنا إذا نريد نذكر عليها شيء عام يعني صراحة اللي موجود عندنا إخواني الأعزاء هذه المنطقة هي الشمالية وهذه المنطقة هي الجنوبية هذه تتطهر من بيت إلى بيت الآن هاي الشمالية انتهت بالصفحة الثالثة لي
We clear this area from our house.
اللي شرعنا ليها من البارحة والأمور ماشية بها بشكل اعتيادي.
We started the south area last night.
إذا يسألني أحدكم بعد أن تنتهي الصفحة الثالثة راح تبتدي الصفحة الرابعة مو عسكرية صفحة إعمار.
After we finish the military operation in phase three, we will start phase four.
هل تتوقع أنه المنطقة هذه ستكون خالية أبدا من الحوادث؟ أقول لك لا. لأنه كمية الأسلحة وكمية الترتيبات اللي موجودة هنا هائل ولكن العمل جاري وبدقة متناهية وهنالك يعني ترتيبات أخرى نتخذها لتطهيرها لأن الفلوجة هي أكبر مخزن للأسلحة في العراق.
We try to clear all the area in the south and in the north because the Fallujah now it's like a big storage for the all kind of the weapons and
أترك الحديث للجنرال سادلر يوضح أيضا موقف القوات الصديقة.
There's nothing else that I want to add to the opening comments, as I realize everyone is here to ask questions. But this has been a combined joint fight from the day we started it. We've had four battalions of Iraqi forces fighting alongside U.S. soldiers, sailors, airmen from above, and Marines. And the operation is going extremely well, and we will continue to press the enemy until we have, in fact, returned Fallujah to the Fallujahan people. Thank you. Please, questions.
Pentagon Press. Gentlemen, good evening. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Well, thank you for joining us back here in the Pentagon this evening also. We'll go ahead and get right into questions here. Go ahead.
Yeah, this is Will Dunham with Reuters. Could you tell us what percentage of the city is now under control? And can you also give us some more details about this situation? If we heard correctly, that 300 insurgents are holed up in a mosque and there's negotiations for them to surrender.
مو يعني أقدر أقول نسبة جدا عالية لم يبقى فيها شيء لأن لم يبقى مكان نحن غير متواجدين به في المدينة. يعني ما أعطي نسباني نهائيا من بدينا لحد الآن، ولكن إحنا متواجدين في كل الفلوجة. القسم الشمالي من الفلوجة يطهر من بيت إلى بيت من الأسلحة. القسم الجنوبي تم التوصل إلى كافة مناطق، ولكن هنالك جيوب يتم تطهيرها حاليا. موضوع ال 300 شخص، 250 إلى 300 شخص تم استسلامهم في أحد الجوانب الجوامع، ولكن من المحتمل أن يكونون من السكان المدنيين. بالرغم من أنه أخبروني لا استسلموا من اللي كانوا مع الإرهابيين، فأنا لا أطرح هذا الموضوع بشكل عام ولكن بشكل دقيق إلى أن تأتيني المعلومات دقيقة جدا ومصورة. ثبت لدينا أنه الإرهابيين اللي موجودين في المنطقة كانوا يجبرون العوائل أن يقاتل معهم واحد أو اثنين من أبنائهم. وكان بحدود الستة هذا اليوم من اللي سلموا نفسهم، وهم كانوا يعني ضمن المقاتلين، بس وضحوا الصورة أنهم مجبرين لأنه أما يقتل أو يقاتل معهم.
Six of the people of the city, they surround themselves today and they said they were fight because they need to fight for they cannot lose. Maybe they should fight or they dead.
I would just add, if we were to use a percentage, that we occupy about 80% of the city right now. But as General Abdelkader mentioned, there's still the clearing of each and every house to take away the caches of weapons and to find the stashes of ammunition. So there is much clearing to be done, even though we occupy about 80% of the town as we speak.
Gentlemen, this is the Pentagon. Before we move to our next question, can we ask that the translator be given a mic or get closer to a mic? We really are not hearing the English translation here.
Okay. They would ask that you come close to the mic. Please, no, you must stay here. You too. I talk very loud. I'm good.
Let's go to our next question here. Eric, go ahead.
General Sattler, Eric Schmidt from the New York Times. I wonder if you can characterize who you believe the resistance is now left in Fallujah. That is, are these members of Zarqawi's network? Are they Islamists? Who exactly is resisting? And have you seen any indications that the insurgents are trying to reinforce the fight from outside Fallujah?
I can't hear it. So الثاني منه منه هم المقاومة وهم صحيح بقيادة الزرقاوي مع الزرقاوي.
I'll answer the second part first. That based on the way that we secured the city from the outside with additional forces that in some cases did not go into the city on the fight, but those that did go into the city, their start point, we choked the city off. We feel very confident that additional forces have been unable to, if they wanted to go and reinforce the city.
القتال ده يتم خارج المدينة من قبل جماعات مسلحة. نحاول إنه إحنا نجاب هذا الموضوع بجماعة المقاومة إذا كانوا هم تابعين للزرقاوي هم من المقاومة.
In the fight up to this point, we have not had the opportunity nor the time to go ahead and analyze who exactly we're fighting. As far as the Iraqi warrior or the U.S. soldier or Marine on the ground is concerned, they are fighting a very stubborn enemy in most cases. And the goal right now is to continue. We feel we've broken their back and their spirit to continue to keep the heat on them. The analysis may come later as to actually who is there. But as far as the warrior on the ground going mano a mano, it's just take care of this fight. Reestablish the rule of law and return the town to the Fallujah people.
القوات العراقية والقوات الأمريكية تتحارب بكل بساطة وتقاتل جابه دولة المقاومة بس لحد الآن ما نقدر نعرف إنه دولة تابعين لمن بس بعدين ورا ما تخلص هذه الأحداث نقدر نكتشف إنه دولة تابعين إلى أي جهة.
Did you want to follow up on the characterization of the resistance? I'm sorry.
Okay, fine. Very good.
Let's go to AFP here then.
General Jim Mannion from AFP. Could you give us your best estimate of the number of insurgents who have been killed at this point? And also, what are your latest casualty toll for U.S. and Iraqi forces, as well as the number of prisoners that you've taken at this point?
القتال يجري اتجاه أشخاص أو اتجاه فكر يدمر الفكر الإسلامي.
We fight the group and the people who destroy the Islamic idea, Islamic thoughts.
القوات العراقية الآن تدافع عن اسم الإسلام لا يدمر.
The Iraqi troops, they defend about the Islamic. We are afraid to destroy the Islamic, these people.
الإسلام يقول لا تقتلوا النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق.
The Islam say don't kill the persons innocent persons without any guilt.
فإحنا ندافع بالضبط عن 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 كل ما ورد في دين الإسلام.
Well, we exactly defend about our religions and the Islamic.
ونعمل على أن لا تكون هنالك فتنة.
And we work together to stop the fight between people.
إذن إحنا نقاتل فكر كان الزرقاوي أو غير الزرقاوي ليهم.
So we fight the idea. We don't fight. We don't care if it's Zarqawi or another one.
General Sadler, could you answer the question?
Is the question that we think we're obviously fighting elements of the Zarqawi network. We've been fighting them now for close to 3 months with precision strikes to shape the battlefield. But as General Abdul Qadir mentioned, this isn't about one individual. This is about breaking the back of the thugs, the terrorists, and the intimidators, so we can return this town to its rightful owner.
Excuse me.
I think the question that they were trying to get to, gentlemen, was can you characterize for us at all in some detail casualties, both friendly casualties, enemy, as well as civilians?
I can't hear.
يريد يعرف انه ايش قد في اعداد قتلى من المدنيين والعسكريين.
On the U.S. casualty, at this point we have lost 22 coalition warriors who made the ultimate sacrifice, and approximately 170 have been wounded, of which today approximately 40 of those have been returned to duty. They were treated, took their weapons, and went back into the fight. As far as enemy casualties, there's been a number estimated of approximately 600. I would say that's a very safe number. But once again, this is an attrition warfare, and we're not counting the enemy as they fall. We're continuing to press the mission.
بالنسبة للعراقيين استشهدوا عندنا 5 وهنالك حدود 40 جريح. جروحهم يعني خفيفة إلى متوسطة.
50 جريح.
بالأربعين جريح.
40 جريح. From the Iraqi side, 5 get killed and 40 wounded.
From the Iraqi side, 5 killed and 40 wounded on the Iraqi Armed Forces side.
And the last part of that question, gentlemen, was there any way that you could provide any detail in terms of numbers on those that may have been captured in this operation, insurgents that have been captured?
We have right now, before the 300 that surrendered at the mosque, we had 151 detainees that we have in our detainee compound. The 300 are being vetted. Those that are civilian, that will be dislocated civilians, are obviously being provided humanitarian assistance, and those who are determined to be hostile will then be put into the detention channels.
قبل ما يسلمون 300 شخص قبل ما يسلمون نفسهم بالجامع كان اكو 151 شخص سلم نفسه قبل هذا العدد.
استسلم
سلم نفسه.
I would like to stress the point that those that the civilians that surrendered today or asked to be taken under control did that with the Iraqi Armed Forces. That was a complete Iraqi Armed Forces operation. There was no U.S. involvement in that.
الأشخاص المدنيين اللي سلموا نفسهم.
الأشخاص المدنيين 140 اللي سلموا نفسهم.
140 شخص.
قامت بها القوات العراقية بالعملية بكاملها. ولم تتدخل فيها القوات المشتركة. وإنما بس الجيش العراقي هو قام تولى عملية استسلام هؤلاء المدنيين.
Yes, back over here to CNN.
General Sattler, Barbara Starr from CNN. Sir, if I could impose upon you to step closer to the mic so we could be very sure to hear you, I'd like to ask you to address in as much detail as you can the current humanitarian situation inside Fallujah. When will you allow the Red Crescent to go in? What is the medical situation, the ability to get food and water and other humanitarian assistance to the civilians that are left in the city? And as you clear these houses and streets, we are seeing pictures, of course, of significant damage to homes and cars. Your plans for making restitution to the civilian population?
As soon as the security situation permits, the Iraqi interim government already has a humanitarian, and I will obviously let the Prime Minister's representative discuss this, already has humanitarian supplies completely lined up and ready to come in to Fallujah.
ناقشنا موضوع الإمدادات الطبية والإغاثة لمدينة الفلوجة ويا رئيس الوزراء وإحنا في طريقنا إلى تنفيذ هذه وصول هذه الإمدادات وتسهيل السبل إليها.
Well, we already sent 14 trucks yesterday. It's very well equipped with the medicine and humanitarian stuff in it, and we are and blood and many things that the civilian will need. And we are going to send some more. It's already been prepared with a group of doctors and personnel who's going to take care of the situation over here in Fallujah. And I believe if the generals over here will give us the green light tomorrow, we will be ready to bring all this equipment over here and we'll start immediately.
Barbara, I'd like to also stress that we have one group of 30 civilians that came out who were taken and moved to a humanitarian assistance area. And then the only other civilians, we had one civilian who was injured, a family of three who was picked up by Iraqi security forces and brought out, and then the approximately 300 that I mentioned earlier that are a combination, we feel, of civilians from Fallujah and possibly some fighters embedded with them. And that is the only families that, the only civilians we've come across.
أريد أضيف إنه هناك مجموعة من 30 شخص من المدنيين واحد من عندهم كان عنده إصابة بليغة والقوات العراقية قوات الأمن العراقية قامت بإنقاذه ونقله إلى مكان آخر.
And the last part of the question concerning the reconstruction, that phase four, actually before phase three is completed, probably in the northern sectors, once security is established and the rule of law is in place, the contracting will start immediately to go ahead and repair damage. The contracts are already on the table. It's just a matter of creating a secure environment to move forward.
ورا ما تكمل المرحلة الثالثة بالجهة الجنوبية راح نحن نخطط نقوم بإعادة أعمار المنطقة وهناك مجموعة من العقود الكثيرة لإعادة أعمار المنطقة وتأهيلها مرة ثانية.
The Iraqi interim government are putting $100 million for the reconstruction of Fallujah. It's already there. Everybody is ready to start the reconstruction of Fallujah, the contractors and the interim government and the people who's in charge of the ministries. So the project's there, the money is there, we are ready to go.
I think we're going to your reporters over there now.
هاون يرمي له مقذوفتين وينهزم. هاي نعرفها بالضبط. واكو هنالك يسمى عندنا وسائل بالطبع استمكان جدا متطوره. وهذه وسائل الاستمكان ده تحدد وفي بعض الأحيان الجواب يكون آلي.
ترجم يعني.
He asked about who made attack outside the city, who fight the people who fight outside the city. The answer was they just attacked by mortars and then they ran away. The other one.
That's it.
Hi,
please.
وبما أن العمليات ستتم في خلال الأيام القليلة متى ستسمحون لأهالي مدينة فلوجة الذين خرجوا بسبب العمليات الإرهابية المدينة إلى أطراف المدينة متى ستسمحون لهم بالعودة؟
بالنسبة يعني للحكومة العراقية طبعا من الأكيد لازم يكون الأمن مستتب في منطقة الفلوجة.
The question was, when you alerted the families to go again to their houses in the city, inside the city, the answer was, the security is very important for the families. And when it becomes complete, 100%, all the families will be back to their homes.
احنا مهيئين للمساعدات الانسانيه والطبيه ومساعدات ماليه financials. مستعدين انه نزود اهالي الفلوجه ونساعدهم بان يعودوا الى بيوتهم وبنفس الوقت راح نعطيهم تعويضات لاعاده بناء بيوتهم
And also we will pay for them preparation to rebuild their houses.
فاحنا باسرع وقت ممكن ان شاء الله يرجعون الى بيوتهم ويعيشون حياه كريمه وبامان ان شاء الله.
Soon as possible they will be back home and they will live in security.
Hi, it's Jim Grant, Associated Press. General Sattler, one of the things that we've heard about is that the curfew and the rules of engagement that are trapping civilians inside the city, all males that are trying to leave have been turned back. Yesterday, I mean, there was a crowd of about 225 people, 200 males were turned back inside the city. And there's this smaller region of this part of the city that's got to be able to stay in, and it's a place that's under constant bombardment and without food or electricity. Wonder if you could explain those rules of engagement that are preventing civilians from leaving the city and why that's necessary.
As was evidenced by this afternoon, those who in fact want to surrender, those who want to go and give themselves up and then go through the vetting process, there is a process in place by virtue of the fact it's ongoing as we conduct this interview. Well, rather than, I'll go ahead and finish. The rules of engagement, the curfew was put in place to protect those warriors who were moving through the town. As you all know, we've been victims of suicide attacks, suicide vehicle-borne improvised explosive devices, cars driving down the street that there's no way to stop and determine whether or not it's a bomb. And if it gets right up on top of you and detonates, we've taken casualties. So that's why the Prime Minister put some very stringent temporary rules into effect for the town of Fallujah, to keep vehicles off the road, to ensure people stayed in their homes until they were approached or they moved forward in a group and surrendered, to make sure that those who were on the streets were not killed unintentionally, assuming that they were part of the murderers and intimidators that I've already talked about. So the intent was to protect them, and as we uncover them, as they surrender, they are in fact being taken care of. So there is no intent to drive everyone back into the town. The last point I would make is that all of the targeting that we have done within the city, each and every strike that's been conducted has been terminally controlled, meaning that the bomb is dropped on a specific target, controlled by a specific individual, and dropped for a specific reason. Either troops in contact, a sniper in the building, or a cache of weapons or ammunition inside that building. We have not, nor will we, conduct indiscriminate bombing with either our aircraft, our helicopters, our fixed wing, or our artillery. That's going to be hard one to
have. No, she's going to
transport. الجواب كان انه احنا ما نريد ياذون اي احد من المدنيين لانه خلصنا من التشجير بالبنايات فهم ما يريدون الاهالي بلده اذا يرجعون لبيوتهم او يحاولون يمشون في الشارع او يعني يحصل لهم اي اذى لهذا السبب هم
الوضع بالفلوجه حسب ما شرح سياده الفريق انه الوضع حساس ودقيق بالنسبه الى المدنيين. نقل المدنيين وتحركات المدنيين بيصير بدقه كثيره لانه اكو سيارات محطوطه للتفجير. وكو سيارات دا ينقتلون فيها مدنيين كثار، فالموضوع بدأ ياخذوه بدقة بخصوص المدنيين. الأهداف اللي تنضرب من خلال الجو أو من خلال البر، فدا تنضرب بدقة ناهية على مود لا تأثر على المدنيين اللي هم قريبين على الدخلاء على العراق. تفضل.
بالنسبة للفرنسي I'm asking about the French-speaking.
Yeah.
I
أي معلومات ممكن تعطينا عن الشخص؟
المعلومات لحد الآن أنه هو يتكلم اللغة الفرنسية. هل هو فرنسي أم من شمال أفريقيا؟ لحد الآن مو واضحة بالنسبة لنا الصورة. قريبا جدا إن شاء الله راح نطلع صور المعتقلين اللي آتين من الخارج، مثل ما سوينا في بغداد وطلعنا صور كثير من الإرهابيين اللي آتين من خارج العراق، والسبب هو تدمير العراق. نفس الوقت راح نجيب الأشخاص اللي راح نمسكوا بالفلوجة وراح نعرضهم للشعب العراقي، وخلي الشعب العراقي يعرف حقائق هالناس وشنو الأسباب اللي خلتهم تجوا لهنا. أنا ما أحب أتكلم على تكهنات، لازم تكون معلومات أكيدة.
فضل.
كويتي.
The question was about the French guy who did I meet today.
Well, actually, he asked me about the French detainees that we have right now. I mean, I cannot say he's a French, but he speaks French fluently. We are checking this issue, and when we will be sure about it, we'll give you the details.
Closing remarks, please. Just thank you. Closing remarks, please.
Sure. طبعاً الحكومة العراقية بقيادة السيد رئيس الوزراء تتحرك على جميع الدول العربية، وبعث السيد رئيس الوزراء مبعوثين إلى الدول العربية من الحكومة العراقية، وكانت اللقاءات ودية. والحمد لله والشكر جابت نتائج، وكان دعم كامل من قبل الحكومة الأردنية، ودعم من الحكومة السعودية، ودعم من الحكومة الكويتية، ودعم كامل من الحكومة المصرية. ولا زالوا المبعوثين من قبل رئيس الوزراء يتجولون في الدول العربية لجمع الدعم لحقوق العراقيين وحقوق الشعب العراقي.
Government with the leadership of Prime Minister, they have a lot of meetings.
Envoy. He just said, excuse me, can I
cut it?
Yeah. The Prime Minister sent an envoy to the Arabic countries, and we explained to the Arabic leaders the situation in Baghdad and the situation of insurgents that have been destroyed our country, and we got full support from Jordan, from Kuwait, from Saudi Arabia, from Egypt. And we are working with them very closely to close up this mess in Iraq, and we have a full support from this country to Iraq.
Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Shukran. Ivan, hang on just a second.